A 59-year-old male has a large growth in his right upper jaw and sinus. Check out the treatment and full surgery today on The Open Reduction. Welcome to The Open Reduction, your channel covering all topics oral and maxillofacial surgery. I'm Dr. Tom Bolton, and today we're removing a massive cyst from a patient's right sinus cavity. This patient is a 59-year-old male who was referred to my office due to a concerning finding on a panoramic radiograph. He has no symptoms, but his dentist noticed an ectopic tooth number 1 that has been gradually moving with time. There is also concern for a lesion associated with this impacted tooth. His clinical exam appears normal, but his 3D cone beam CT tells a different story. There is a large unilocular radiolucent lesion in the right maxilla and sinus associated with an impacted tooth number 1. The lesion appears to be filled with fluid and it is causing bony expansion into the sinus cavity. The wisdom tooth is medially displaced and horizontal. It's at the level of the patient's nasal floor. The treatment of this involves removal of the ectopic wisdom tooth, tooth number 1, removal of the lesion, and submitting all of the tissue to the pathologist to obtain a definitive diagnosis. This will be performed under IV sedation. Once this patient is asleep and anesthetized, I make a full thickness incision along the sulcus of the teeth and create a vertical release anteriorly. I elevate the flap and expose the lateral wall of the sinus. Next, I aspirate the contents of this lesion. I make a bony window to gain access to the sinus. Here is the lining of the lesion coming into view. I remove a small portion of the lining to visualize the impacted tooth. and then remove additional bone. Now that I can visualize the tooth, I mobilize it with an elevator. The free-floating tooth falls deeper into the sinus, and I retrieve it with a hemostat. We can see this tooth is covered in the creamy fluid within this cyst. There is a large amount of thick brown fluid within the lesion. Now, I use a rongeur to remove the cyst lining. Here is the lining of the cyst. This lining measures 7 centimeters, which is huge for this area. I curette the bony walls and rinse thoroughly. There's no additional cyst lining. Now I obtain a primary closure. Thankfully, this lesion came back as a dentigerous cyst, and no additional intervention is necessary. Thanks so much for watching. Please click those like and subscribe buttons and check out the channel for additional cool OMFS cases like this one. Also, visit my website, theopenreduction.com, for advanced continuing education courses and credit. I'm Dr. Tom Bolton. I'll catch you next time on The Open Reduction.